Hi, my name is Tommy, and today I want to talk about monorepos. If you have a complex project that consists of many moving parts, a well-executed monorepo can give you an edge that can help you and your team be more productive. In this video, we'll see what a monorepo is, why it might be a good workflow for you, and the open source tools specifically designed for working with monorepos. Windows, for example, is all in one repository. The opposite of a monorepo is multiple repos. This is how we usually think of code and repositories. We can compose a monorepo starting for multiple repos and joining all the code bases on a single repository. We end up with a large repository with lots of folders. But why would we do that? There are a few benefits that we can only get with monorepos. Visibility. Everyone can see everyone else's code. This property leads to better collaboration and cross-team contribution. Unified dependency management. Sharing dependencies is trivial. There's little need for a package manager when we have all the libraries in the same repository. All packages on the monorepo share the same version, so there are no version conflicts and no dependency hell. We can enforce code quality standards and practices across all the components of the monorepo. Having a shared timeline means that breaking changes in the APIs or shared libraries are exposed immediately. As soon as someone breaks some compatibility layer, all the rest of the packages fail. That exposes the problem immediately. This is a great incentive to keep everyone invested in keeping up with changes. Having all the code in one repository allows us to make huge changes across all packages in one commit. We also get implicit continuous integration. We are guaranteed that all the code is already unified in one place. We can unify the build process to have one build tool to build all the packages and to test them all together. But the main benefit boils down to Conway's law. He said that the communication structure of a team or an organization influences on the design of the system. In other words, the main benefit that monorepos bring is that they break the communication barriers between teams. The monorepo imposes a structure where different teams have to work together. They have to find a way to communicate effectively to work together. Of course, choosing a monorepo also has its downsides. Performance can be tricky due to the large size of the repo. Commands like git blame may take a long time to execute, and IDEs can lag and the productivity suffer. Also, master or main is easy to break. A single commit on one package can break the trunk. This can be viewed as a downside or an upside. On one side, knowing that master is broken is better than not knowing about it, but on the downside, it's also very frustrating how easy master is to break. The learning curve is also more steeper than when we have multiple repositories because you have a large code base and getting into that is more daunting. Monorepos can grow in gigabytes of size or terabytes of size. These large sizes can mean unwieldy volumes of data and commits per day, which need to be managed in some way. Maintaining ownership of files is more challenging because everything is together, and systems like Git or Mercurial don't have built-in some code ownership mechanism to control who can commit into where. Code reviews are also more complex because we are going to get a lot of code reviews, a lot of communications and notifications that are not related to the project or the packages you are working with. So you need a better system for making code reviews. So let's see a few monorepo projects to see how the repositories look. So here's React. React is a known monorepo. At first sight, you can't tell if this is a monorepo, but upon further inspection, when you see the folder structure of the project, we can determine that there's a heavy monorepo influence here. If we go into the packages folder, we're going to see all the packages that are part of React, and all these packages are not necessarily part of a React installation because some of them are plugins, some of them are core components, and if we enter any of these tools, we're going to see some typical structure, source code, a README, and some dependency declarations here. But this is a very typical structure for a monorepo when we have all the components, each in its own folder. The node module folder is normally hosted up, and there's one source of dependencies for the whole project, which keeps things simple and a very low chance of conflicts. Vavel is another monorepo project, and we can also see here the same structure. We have a packages folder, and here we are going to see all the components. Again, some of these are core components, and some are plugins that can be installed or not. They are optional components of Vavel, depending on your needs. And again, entering one of these folders shows a kind of a template directory structure where you have the same files across all the packages. So let's see what tools there are out there to handle monorepo. We need to build to handle dependencies and to test everything, ideally when things change. This is Bazel. This is the open source version of Google's internal build system, which is called Blaze. Bazel supports many languages and is capable of building and testing at scale. It takes a little while to get used to how it works, but once you know how it works, it's very useful and powerful. And again, this is based on the Google experience, which has one of the, if not the, largest monorepo out there. Then we have Back. This is Facebook's open source fast build systems, supports multiple languages, differential builds, and multiple platforms. Pants is another very well-known build system. It was created in collaboration with Twitter, or X, Foursquare, and Square. For the moment, it only supports Python, but there are more languages on the way. Microsoft scalable monorepo solution is Rust.js. This is a monorepo manager for JavaScript, and is capable of building and deploying many packages from a single repository. Many of the tools you already know and use have monorepo support. For example, NPM has added workspaces on version 7, and Yarn has had this feature since version 1. In case you were wondering, our product, Semaphore CI, has out-of-the-box support for monorepos. It uses change detection to only run the jobs, test, and build steps for the code that changed and skips the rest. This makes it very easy to run continuous integration on large monorepos. Source control is another pain point for monorepo. We have a large amount of commits, a big repository, and a large number of people working together. And normally, source control systems are not built for that scale. So here are some tools that will help. Virtual file system for Git adds streaming support for Git. This is a Microsoft open source solution. They use that for handling their Windows code base. For the moment, it works only on Windows and Mac OS. Large file storage for Git is an open source extension for Git that adds support for large files. Once installed, it tracks large files using pointers, so you don't need to download and upload large files on every commit. And large files are kept separate on a cloud storage, for example, or some network storage. This makes pushing and pulling from the Git repository much faster. Code owners is a feature from GitHub and GitLab that protects files and branches. We define who owns which directories, and the system will not let people outside of that team from changing those files. Finally, Mercurial. This is an alternative to Git. It's a different source control version system. It's being used by Facebook, and they have pushed a few extensions for Mercurial to manage large files and large repositories. So Mercurial may be a good alternative to Git because it has built in more extensions to manage monorepos. That's all I have for today. What do you think of monorepos? If you are in doubt, consider that moving from a monorepo to a multi-repo is easier than the other way around. So if you are just starting, why not just try a monorepo and see how it works? Starting from zero is definitely easier and will give you plenty of space to learn and scale your products as you grow. That's all for today. Thank you for watching this video to the end. I hope you liked it. If you did, why don't you leave a like and maybe subscribe? I can't understate how much it motivates me to make more and better videos. Thank you for watching, and take care, you all.